Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, Abstract Algebra, Group Theory Classes, Class Number 40. Let us see a result, depends upon previous class. Let H be a subgroup of a group G and small a is an element of G. Then the equivalence class, observe the word, then the equivalence class containing the element A, the equivalence class containing the element A, with respect to the relation congruence modulo H, with respect to the relation congruence modulo H is denoted by A bar, is denoted by A bar. What it means? A bar is equals to set of those elements X belongs to the group G. A bar is equals to set of the elements from G, from the group G, which satisfies this condition X is congruent to A mod H. X is congruent to A mod H. So, the set of all elements which satisfies the definition of congruence modulo H is known as equivalence class. Is known as equivalence class. And it is denoted by A bar. Depends upon this result, there is a theorem. This one. Let H, dot be a subgroup of a group G, dot. For an element A belongs to G, the equivalence class A bar, for an element A belongs to G, the equivalence class A bar is equals to X belongs to G such that X is congruent to A mod H, then A bar is equals to AH, then A bar is equals to AH. This A bar means equivalence class containing A is equivalent to the left coset AH, is equivalent to the left coset AH. Let us prove this theorem. Let G, dot be a group and A is an element of G, H, dot be a subgroup of G, the equivalence class A bar is defined by A bar is equals to X belongs to G such that X is congruent to A mod H. We have to prove that A bar is equals to AH. We have to prove that A bar is equals to AH. A bar is equivalence class containing A. A bar is equivalence class containing A. AH means left coset generated by A. Left coset of the subgroup H generated by A. Our aim is to show that A bar is equals to AH. To prove this, let us take an element, E be the identity element in G. Small e be the identity element. Let E be the identity element. Let E be the identity element in G as well as in H. We know that identity element is same in the group and in the subgroup. Let us take an element X belongs to A bar. Let us take an element X belongs to A bar. By the definition of A bar, X belongs to A bar implies and implied by, X belongs to A bar implies and implied by, X is congruent to A mod H. X is congruent to A mod H. That is the definition of A bar. By the definition of A bar, X belongs to A bar means X is congruent to A mod H. X is congruent to A mod H. Implies and implied by. What is the definition of congruence modulo H? A inverse X belongs to H. A inverse X belongs to H. For our convenience, take A inverse X is equals to H. For our convenience, take A inverse X is equals to H. What it means? Implies and implied by, A inverse X is equals to H, belongs to H for some H belongs to capital H. Operate on both the sides. operate on both the sides with A. Operate on both the sides with A. Implies and implied by A into A inverse X is equals to AH belongs to A left coset. You observe that this is the very, very important step here. A inverse X is equals to H belongs to capital H. We multiply each and every term with A. We multiply each and every term with A. A into A inverse X is equals to AH belongs to A capital H. This is the left coset. Apply the associative axiom. Apply the associative axiom. A into A inverse into X is equals to AH belongs to AH. Belongs to AH. Every time you don't need to write AH, which is implies and implied by EX belongs to AH. EX belongs to AH. You can write one more time. EX is equals to AH. EX is equals to AH. Belongs to the left coset AH. Belongs to the left coset AH. Implies and implied by X is equals to or X belongs to AH. What it means? You take X belong, you take the element X is lies in A bar, X belongs to A bar. You prove that X belongs to AH with implies and implied by condition. Therefore, X belongs to A bar implies and implied by X belongs to A bar implies and implied by X belongs to AH. This concludes that A bar is equals to left coset AH. A bar is equals to left coset AH. Our aim is also same. We have to prove that A bar is equals to AH. Observe that. Next theorem. If capital H is a subgroup of a group G, then there is one-to-one correspondence between the set of all distinct left cosets of H in G and the set of all distinct right cosets of H in G. Observe that. H is a subgroup of G. H is a subgroup of a group G. Then there is a one-to-one correspondence between the set of all distinct left cosets of H in G and the set of all distinct right cosets of H in G. Yes, let us prove this statement. Capital G be a group, H be a subgroup of G. Define G1 is equals to set of all distinct left cosets of H in G. Capital G1, set of all distinct left cosets of H in G. Left cosets means set of AH such that A belongs to G. G2 be the set of all distinct right cosets of H in G. That is equals to HA such that A belongs to capital G. We have to prove that there is a one-to-one correspondence between these two sets. To prove that, define a function or define a mapping from G1 to G2. Define a mapping F maps G1 into G2 by F of AH is equals to HA inverse for all AH belongs to means left coset belongs to G1. Define a mapping F maps G1 to G2 by F of AH is equals to HA inverse for all AH belongs to G1. So we wish to prove that F is a one-to-one correspondence. One-to-one correspondence means it is both one and onto function. It is both one and onto function. First, we show that F is well defined. To prove that F is well defined. Yes, you define like this, but is it possible to define in this way? You have to check that. You have to check that the defined mapping is a well-defined mapping or not. To prove that it is well-defined, let us take two left cosets, AH, BH belongs to G1. Suppose AH, BH belongs to G1 are two left cosets. Suppose ए एच इज इक्वल्स टू बी एच, द लेफ्ट कोसेट ए एच इज इक्वल्स टू बी एच बाई प्रीवियस थ्योरम. द लेफ्ट कोसेट ए एच इज इक्वल्स टू बी एच मीन्स बी इनवर्स इन टू ए बिलोंग्स टू एच. एच इज ए सब ग्रुप, वॉट इट मीन्स बी इनवर्स इन टू ए होल इनवर्स बिलोंग्स टू एच. एच इज ए सब ग्रुप, इट मीन्स एवरी एलिमेंट हैज इनवर्स एलिमेंट, देयरफॉर बी इनवर्स ए होल पावर माइनस वन बिलोंग्स टू एच. Implies A inverse into B inverse whole inverse belongs to H. Implies A inverse B belongs to H. A inverse B belongs to H. A inverse B belongs to H means HA is equals to HB. What it means? F of AH A inverse B belongs to H. A inverse B belongs to H. So don't take this step. You put it as it is. A inverse B inverse whole inverse belongs to H. Which implies HA inverse is equals to HB inverse. This condition implies as HA inverse is equals to HB inverse. HA inverse can be written as F of AH is equals to F of BH. Therefore, we prove that AH is equals to BH. AH is equals to BH implies F of AH is equals to F of BH. This shows us F is well defined. This shows us F is well defined. Observe the derivation part. AH is equals to BH are left cosets in G1. Suppose AH is equals to BH. We have a theorem. Already we learned a theorem in cosets. AH is equals to BH implies and implied by B inverse A belongs to H. B inverse A belongs to H. We learned this theorem. By applying this theorem, B inverse A belongs to H. B inverse A whole inverse also belongs to H. This step applicable whenever H is a subgroup. Subgroup means it is a group. By inverse axiom, B inverse A whole inverse belongs to H. We know that AB whole inverse is equals to B inverse into A inverse. By applying this condition, you get this step. A inverse B inverse whole inverse belongs to H. Again we learn a theorem. You observe that A B inverse belongs to H implies and implied by H A is equals to H B. A B inverse belongs to H implies and implied by H A is equals to H B. In this theorem, replace B inverse by B. You get this. Implies and implied by H A inverse is equals to H B inverse. You observe that. So by using previous theorems, the mapping clearly F is well defined. The mapping which is defined here, F of A H is equals to H A inverse for all A H belongs to G, is clearly well defined. Yes, let us continue our theorem. Next we prove that F is a 1-1 map. To prove that F is 1-1. 1-1 is nothing but converse of well-defined. So we take F of AH is equals to F of BH. Complete converse part of well-defined. Suppose. F of AH is equals to BH. So by applying the definition of mapping, you get F of AH is equals to F of BH. You get HA inverse is equals to HB inverse. HA inverse is equals to HB inverse means A inverse B inverse whole inverse belongs to H. Belongs to H. A inverse, B inverse, whole inverse belongs to H means. Belongs to H means. B inverse A whole inverse belongs to H. It means B inverse A belongs to H. It means AH is equals to BH. AH is equals to BH. Therefore, we prove that. F of AH is equals to F of BH implies as AH is equals to BH. Therefore, F is 1-1. Therefore, F is 1-1. You observe that this procedure is nothing but converse of well-defined. In the proof of well-defined, we prove the converse of these steps. You observe that. The next part is to prove that F is onto. What is the definition of onto? Every element of the codomain has at least one pre-image in the domain. Every element of codomain has at least one pre-image in the domain. To prove that onto function, let us take an element HA belongs to. Let us take an element HA belongs to G2. G2 is the codomain, right coset. G2 is the codomain. Comma where A belongs to G. Comma where A belongs to G. Since A belongs to G and G is a group. And G is a group. Apply the inverse axiom. Apply the inverse axiom. So A inverse belongs to G. A inverse belongs to G. If A inverse belongs to G, then what happens? A inverse into H belongs to G1 left coset. A inverse into H belongs to G1 left coset. Such that by definition of F of A inverse H is equals to H A inverse whole inverse. You get H A. You observe that for H A belongs to G2 codomain, there exists an element A inverse H belongs to G1, which is known as domain, such that F of A inverse H is equals to HA. This shows as F is onto. F is onto. Therefore, we conclude that F max G1 to J2 is both 1-1 and onto. Is both 1-1 and onto. G1 is the set of all left distinct left cosets. G2 is the set of all distinct right cosets. Therefore, there exists a 1-to-1 correspondence. There exists a 1-to-1 correspondence from the set of left cosets of H in G into the set of right cosets of H in G. In both the cases, these are distinct. In both the cases, these are distinct. Distinct right cosets, distinct left cosets. You observe that. This completes the proof. Hence proved. Practice these two theorems. Keep learning. These are very, very important theorems. Because of they play a vital role while learning the partitions of a group in higher classes. Keep learning.